Hello champions, welcome to another episode of Rus. My name is Champion Ever and today we are playing another 6 player fixed card game which is being played on the Europe Advanced map with Blizzard. I'm the 6th red player in this game and I see I could go for one of these two continents, either Southeastern Europe or the Nordic Alps. Think that would be the best choice for me. The black player goes for Iceland, he doesn't have that many troops to guard it for, but yeah, basically it's either me or White who could wipe him out, but if not then he takes over one point guard noob corner. Let's go black. Right, he will send alliance requests to all of those players to increase the probability of me successfully holding my continent or continents in case I get more than one. Nobody so far accepts my alliance requests. The purple player just did. Let's send him a thumbs up and a thumbs up for the white player and a heart as well. Good. The green player decides to go for Orient over here, which I'm not a fan of, with me wanting to take over Southeastern Europe. And the pink player goes for the Nordic Alps. Not a fan, too much of it either. Why is he doing 4 versus 2 blitz over here? He must be a lower ranked player, guys. Do not like my turn order, guys, because right here, if I take over Southeastern Europe, the pink player could just break through me. Or if I break through the pink player first, then the pink player just goes into a war with me, so a lose-lose situation for me either way. And like predicted, guys, the white player goes for the noob corner. Let's go, 1 point. Noob corner, will he make it for? 3 versus 1 will be 89% blitz, and let's go, let's go. The pink player accepts my alliance request. Let's send him a thumbs up. Not sure how that works out, but hopefully that will work out. Basically, I cannot go for another continent unless I want to take over Scandinavia. Do I want to take over Scandinavia? In Southeastern Europe, I would be in between green and pink. But since Scandinavia is a single point border, guys, I think I might take over Scandinavia instead. Let's go after Scandinavia. Yes. The white player sends me a thumbs up, but right here, let's wait to fortify my troops because I'm running out of time. Let's send a thumbs up back for the white player. Let's send a thumbs up back for the pink player and a thumbs up for the green player. As well, right here, the black player retaliates back to the white player and instantly takes the last 6 place. He raises the white flag. I switch my decision to rather go for Iceland, so because I wouldn't be in between pink and green. Basically, I will be trapped in between and couldn't go for another continent. Right here, I could potentially take over the Russian Empire, maybe Eastern Europe. Or in case the pink player doesn't go for Southeastern Europe, maybe I will still go for it myself. Obviously, if I can, I take over it, but I kinda see it more as a temporary continent. But no, the pink player will go, or will he go into Italy? No. And actually, guys, see, in Italy there's an Italy flag. Wow, Italy flag in Italy, let's go. Thumbs up for the pink player, I do not appreciate it, but what can I do about that? Right here, you want to be in a warm alliance with other players. Attack pink, the white player says. No, I'm not going to attack pink. My first priority is to take over continents myself. And in this case, I would like to expand into the Russian Empire. Or could I go for Central Europe, guys? That might be a tempting choice as well, considering I have alliance with both players. Let's actually do it, guys. I could take over France, but right here would be trapped in between purple and white, so it wouldn't be a good choice. So because of that reason, I'm just simply taking over Germany right here. Let's wipe out the pink player from over here, guys, just so that he wouldn't decide to add his troops in Ruskiala and wipe us out from 1 point. Hold. The purple player adds more troops in Southwestern Europe, and I assume either him or White would like to expand into Western Europe, aka France. The purple player will receive +4 troops a turn. Fortifies those troops into Gascony, so kinda prevents the white player from going for it. The green player is the only player without a continent so far, besides the black player who already disconnected. And will you break through me, green? Don't you break through me, I hope. I thought we are allies. Take over here, I do not care. Take over 2 troop territory you want. have North Africa either way. Let's send a thumbs up for the pink player, because the pink player, it is growing so strong and might be the most influential player in this game so far. It's up to him so far which player to attack, and right here he adds more troops in Istanbul, which is something what I like, because he prevents the green player from going from Orient. The green player might take it very personally and break through the pink player's counter. Could potentially consider going for Italy, Southern Europe, but basically it would split the map into a very bad way, guys. I will send a thumbs up for the white player, and what should I do next? I think I would like to expand over here, but I guess I won't do it too fastly to not bring the attention of other players to myself. The purple player will expand into West Africa, and the question is, what is the white player's plan about that? I would assume the white player would like to take over France, and not only it, but over Spain by himself alone. But yeah, the purple player fortifies those troops back to Gascony for a reason. You understand that as well. For the white players right here in the advantage, it will be more up to the white player to decide what does he want to do about that. The pink player gets wiped out from over here. The green player must not appreciate the pink player for sure. That's something what I really like right here, guys, because in this way it increases my chances of taking over Russian Empire and successfully holding it. Because if pink and green players were friends, basically the green player then would have to attack into the Russian Empire to not get card blocked. Let's see what does the white player do. A complicated situation for the white player, because I think he have to fight it out with a purple player in some way. Or should he? Obviously those players should be in some kind of dissatisfaction, guys. Attack pink. White player says, well, I do not want to attack him. I would like to add some more troops over here. I want to add some more troops over here as well. And possibly take over the Russian Empire. Right here I'm wiping out black. Basically the black player could be taken by the purple player. Right here I do not care, because the purple player will probably waste his troops on white or something. And right here let's just simply take over the Russian Empire if I get a good blitz. Let's go. Let's fortify some more troops over right here. The white player sends that emote. He acts surprised. He wants to bring other players awareness on myself, but hopefully other players will stay friends. Let's see if a purple player gets good blitz over here. Yes, right here it's 100% blitzes to eliminate the black player from the game and trade in assets. Let's go. Yeah, it was kind of up to me. It's better to let the purple player eliminate black or not. I could have delayed taking over the Russian Empire and left the black player in Kharkiv. Here is the green player stunning. There's basically no reason for the green player to break from me when he doesn't have any continent himself. It would be in his best interest to first of all get a continent for himself. 12 troops received by the pink player. Let's see what does the pink player do. I think the pink player would like to wipe out the green player behind himself, because if the green player will be an issue to one of the players, then he will be an issue to pink. I'm sorry, but I need to attack your territory. Okay, I will send you a heart back. Right, if you just break through over here, then that's fine. But please, no more than that. Or do you want to attack for Naples? Okay, attack pink. Attack a thumbs up. Well, attack pink. Attack pink right here. Right here, if you attack pink, I think I could attack the pink player as well, or should I? Right here, I'm not quite sure about white. Okay, he is delaying time right here. No, he isn't attacking pink. He isn't attacking pink right here, guys. Yeah, basically it wouldn't be smart for me to attack pink, but I can attack pink over here. Let's see to which player the purple player will be an issue to. I've been really hoping that he would be an issue for the white player, but we question whether that will be the case. The white player is kind of fine with the purple player holding those continents behind him. Basically the purple player might be the biggest threat for me in this game, guys. Because right here the green player will cause some issues to pink. When the white player either attacks me or stays neutral, and basically nobody cares, nobody takes care of the purple player. For the green player just deploys his troops like that, and that's it. The pink player will trade in a set, and let's see what will be the plan of the pink player. I like him splitting troops into multiple different armies. This way it will be harder for him to navigate through the map, for he's playing more defensively over here. Right here you can take over Eastern Europe. I do not mind. Yes, let's go. I will send you a thumbs up. The white player is questioning something. Yeah, basically it would be stupid, it will be dumb for me, and pink players to go in a conflict and let other players to make a comeback. Right here, white players, more troops, please swipe out purple. No, you do not. Well, right here, let's add 4 troops, guys. Let's trade an asset. I will guard my 1-point guard. Let's just simply capture a territory over here, and that's it. Let's fortify those troops into the border. On one hand, it would be great that the purple player got wiped out from Jezenty, but on the other hand, he would still have territories to attack in Italy, so after all, it doesn't too much matter. Will he even take over it? Here's the question. I do not like that. Do not like it. I will send him a thumbs up, but I do not like it. Do not like it. Basically, right here will be prevented from getting cards if I do not want to break through either one of those players. For the green player, possibly moves out from Georgia. If that's the case, then I can still attack right here. And no, puts his troops back. Come on, you green. Oh well, I will rather still skip a turn than end up risking getting into a big conflict with another player and basically just end up being left with Scandinavia alone. Not sure what is the plan of a green player, but in case one of his stacks got crushed, I wouldn't mind to eliminate him from the game over here, because he's kinda blocking the way. Right here, to avoid getting attacked by purple, I will stack some more troops, but I will just send my turn. But right here, if a purple player wants, then please break through pink. Didn't want to risk him potentially breaking through Bavaria, guys. Even if a purple player doesn't have a territory to attack, which wouldn't be somebody's continent, he's definitely not attacking 48th army of the white plane Burgundy, and he doesn't even have enough accessible troops anyway. Will he just skimp? Simply quit the game, which would be hilarious. Okay, he's offline. Yeah, that's weird why some players just simply quit the game like that. For it, I still wouldn't dare. I still wouldn't dare to break through the purple player, because who knows, maybe after a turn or two he will still come back. Maybe I should break through him. Maybe I should. The pink player keeps fortifying more troops to Hungary, something I do not like too much, guys, because right here he's accessible to attack in Prussia. He's paying the most attention to me. Well, I would like that he would prioritize wiping out the green player from over here. At this point, I think it would be even better for me to keep the green player alive, because he would keep preventing the pink player from taking over Orient. Well, the purple player is still offline, guys. I think I will just simply break through him. Oh well. Yes, offline. Right here, after 10 minutes, he will take the last available place. He will go MIA, and yeah, basically will get 5th place, so unless somebody else gets eliminated from the game, which could, for example, be the green player or the white player. Let's see, green, what do you do? Please make that blitz. Make that blitz, you might even wipe out the white player for sure, guys. But basically, I shouldn't over attack, knowing what the pink player is the biggest threat in this game. Even if a white player gets wiped out from Arabia, I do not think it would be smart for me to wipe him out from the noob corner, knowing what the pink player could take a huge advantage out of that. The green player keeps attacking, well, not that many territories. He doesn't even show big intention towards taking over a continent. And when the purple player even for disconnected for now, he might still come back to the game in a period of 10 minutes. But here the pink player fortifies his troops from Hungary to Vienna, which on one hand is something what I like, and on the other hand something what I do not like. Right here I like about that is right here he's suitable to attacking other players as well, but I do not like because it feels more threatening. It feels a little bit more threatening. Yeah, basically I do not care. Either way, guys, right here let's add more troops. Right here let's add more troops. Right here attack pink. Attack pink, he says. No, I'm not attacking pink. Right here, if I and pink players fight, we would let you make a comeback. What which chances for you to make a comeback would highly increase. I won't attack pink, so unless I guess the pink player attacks me first, or unless I see what I have a big advantage on the board, I could take over a very big advantage. But at this point, I attack pink, the pink player attacks me back, and you white gets good chances to make a comeback. Well, basically me and pink would make ourselves to be eliminated. The green player, will he smack those 10 troops? Yes, let's go. Something I really like a lot. Wow, it was so much worth it to leave the green player alive, guys. Good. For that's not for a long time, guys. The pink player will just eliminate the green player from the game soon. Will he make that blitz? Right here, there would be one card if I want to eliminate green. Okay, he smacks those troops. Smacks those troops, guys. Alliance is over. The green player takes the last available place. Which in this case is the 5th place, so the power player luckily gets the 4th place, assuming nobody else gets eliminated before he goes MIA. The white player trades in a certain ideal, I would prefer him adding more troops in Mech and Medina, but no he does not. Ah, no he does not. But right here, purple, I mean pink and white have more troops when I combined. Do not like that, guys. Otherwise, I might consider eliminating one of them from the game, but right here, let's basically crush a 4 troop army of a purple player. Even for technical, I could have attacked the territory over here, guys. I could have added more troops, or even right here. But basically, added those troops, so right here, it wouldn't be so obvious for the white player, but I'm adding more troops next to him on purpose. Yes, who knows, I might still decide to eliminate him from the game, guys. Bad thing is, right here, what the purple player right here, kinda makes the map being way smaller, in case there were no purple player, but the white and pink player still had the same number of troops, it would be better for me, because the map would be bigger and I could attack more territories, but okay, the white player gets wiped out from over half of the pink players, leaving one troop territory of the green player behind. OMG, OMG, guys. Will the pink player break through me or not? Attack pink. Okay, MIA, the purple player is MIA, guys. Okay, attack pink. Okay, I will send a thumbs up, please. Attack pink and I will send you a heart. Is white player fast? Okay, a thumbs up. Okay, attack pink, yes. Thumbs up, please. Attack pink as well. Please attack pink. And, well, basically 60. Okay, thumbs up. Yes, a thumbs up. If you attack pink, I'm definitely attack pink for sure. Okay, but you do not attack. Let's see what kind of a blitz roll will we get over here. Let's go. Okay, good blitz, guys. Good blitz. Let's go. Over here, can I eliminate the pink player from the game right here, guys? Okay, I accidentally make it, but oh well. Okay, right here, let's eliminate the green player from the game. Okay, let's go right here, guys, and we'll end our turn. 10 troops received by pink, pink player obviously trades on the seat, but he will obviously go through. Or maybe not, he might not go through. Right here, guys, maybe he just simply goes into the 1 point Scandinavia. So here let's send a thumbs up for the white player, and I will send a hat, attack pink. Let's see if you keep your promise, let's see. Right here, basically I am still strong, guys. But yeah, the white player right here will be in the lead once he gets to make his turn. I mean, even if he makes a passive move, it's still good. It's still good for me as long as the white player doesn't attack me. But if he doesn't, I hope he goes after the pink player, but no, he goes after me, I see. Or no. Okay, I guess he's splitting those troops for the pink player. Okay, so he's keeping the promise. Yes, that's a very honorable play. At first I thought he's just breaking through my continents, but yeah, basically he wanted to wipe out the pink player from over here. Why are you splitting those troops right here in Ankara? Okay, well, basically it made me much more damage, guys, man. Then the pink player wiped out, when the white player wiped out pink. 34 troops and 31 troops of the pink players right here. Well, let's actually wipe out the pink player from over here, guys, still. Okay, hopefully you do not have a set pink. Hopefully you do not have a set. Yes, you do not. Okay, I will send attack pink, attack my territory if you need to, and I will send you a heart. Okay, most importantly, you wouldn't crush my 59 troop army right here to get the attacker's advantage. Or just make a passive turn and let me hold those continents. Let's see, right here, it didn't break for a reason. Into the white player, so to potentially, what he would potentially let me hold those continents right here. Thumbs up. Yes, yes, he lets me hold those continents. Yes, I'm eliminating pink. Yes, thumbs up. Let's add those troops over here, guys. I'm blitzing. Eliminating the pink player from the game, that's the best. What can I do? Because if I leave a pink player alive, a pink player will just be looking to retaliate to me. And it will be much harder for me to win. Well, right here, I hope that the white player wouldn't want to attack territories that fast, but maybe he will still do that, guys. Okay, 23 troops received by me, guys. Let's go take over those continents. Let's break through the white player over here. Let's see what can we do over here after all. Okay, basically, I'm capturing all of those territories besides that 4 troop army. And basically, if I fortify my army over here, then the pink player, I mean, the white player will have to, yeah, he will have to unleash it in some way or another. But he didn't want to fortify my army next to the white player because he might not crush it. He might just go around it, guys. Let's see. Well, if I fortified that army next to him, it would have encouraged him to crush it. Yeah. Here I have my 10 troop army is blocked. And the white player is actually attacking territories really fast, guys. Okay, now he goes into that direction. Unfortunately, takes the attacker's advantage. I was hoping he wouldn't. Please. And your turn, White. Achim, White Lee is so fast, guys. He's so fast. I think I'm losing again. Six troops received by Metu. At least I hold a continent. Still, guys, let's go to breakthrough. I love the noob corner. Okay, good game. He says, is that a good game or is it still not? But here, let's go take over Wusa additional territories, guys, because who knows? Who knows? Maybe. Yeah, it will be more continents for the White player to break through. Okay, where will I fortify my troops? Because I can split two troops like that. Yes. Let's fortify both 10 troops. The 10 troop army over here. 10 troops received by White. White player won't have a set. Won't have a set right here. He has split those troops to break through my continent. He has the territorial advantage, guys, but he still has to break through some of my continents to prevent me from receiving a bunch of them. Okay, he will go into the first straight line, good pathing, and 100%. And technically, he could still do man rolls and might have enough luck to break through Scandinavia as well. Let's see. He fortifies. Please fortify with 7 troops to the noob corner in London. Okay, now let's go right here. The game is not necessarily over, guys. Right here, let's try taking over both additional territories. Should I go after territories or should I try blitzing his troops? His 4 or 7 troop army. Let's go after the territories because he has so many of them, guys. He has so many. Let's go over here. And okay, he will still receive a lot, unfortunately. But let's put some more troops right here to protect noob corner. 7 troops received by him, and he also got a set. He is lucky to have a set at 3 cards on the overhand. I got lucky to have a set myself as well. But yeah, basically he is still in the advantage, guys. And in a big advantage as long as he breaks through all of my borders. Okay, 5 versus 4, please fail it. Yes, let's go, let's go. That's lucky for us. For me, that wasn't favorable blitz roll he made. Right here, 3 versus 1, please fail. No, 89% goes. Then successful for 2 versus 1 right here was troop waste. Not sure why he did that. And okay, well, I'm at still 18 territories. I will receive 6 troops plus 2 troops for Iceland. 8 troops total. Good. 1 more troop. Over here, let's obviously trade in a set, guys. Where do I want extra 2 troops, which might be crucial to the territory? Where should I want? Okay, Prussia. Prussia, let's go. Okay, good game, he says. Let's actually put some more troops over here, guys, to take over the noob corner and guard it. Let's actually split some more troops as well to make the him split or not. Well, I might not have enough troops to still break through those. Well, let's set up because I'm definitely running out of time, guys. Let's take over those, and yes, I will be in a relatively good position. Okay, phew, I made it in time to fortify 3 troops over here, meaning quite a bad player. Has to add more troops right here in Hungary as well to break through my continent. After all, it looks like I'm outplaying a white player in that 2-player endgame, guys. I didn't expect that, honestly. I thought once the white player got the attacker's advantage on my biggest army in Hungary, he is winning the game. With him attacking fast, okay, bad blitz, bad blitz. Bad blitz, and 3 versus 3 is a very low percent chance, and yeah, good game. Well played, thanks. Aha. Yeah, at this point, I'm taking over the advantage. I end up holding even 3 continents, guys. Let's add more troops over here, and you're sending me the surrendering flag, I see. Yes. Yippee, let's go. Let's wipe you out from over here. Let's attack you over here as well, White. Basically, let's take over those continents. And 5 troops goes right here. He's still trying to break through my continents. He's still trying to win even before the situation is miserable. Oh, ho, 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 ho. General love. 3 versus 1. You're doing man roll. Why are you doing man roll? Maybe just to waste your troops completely. 39 troops. How many troops should I add over here, guys? 10 maybe, and the rest of those here, not 27. Well, okay, 15 will be more than enough, and right here 30 will be more than enough. And yeah, good game, general dub. Let's go, let's go. Yes, general thumbs up, and let's wipe out the white player from over here. Good game, well played. I will send you a fist bump, I guess. And yes, that is going to be a GG, guys. Let's continue wiping out the white player from over here, and let's see. We'll see what were the ranks of my opponents. Especially I'm interested to find out the rank of a white player. Is he a master? Okay, grandmaster. Wow, we beat a grandmaster ranked player, guys. Let's go.